Hey, it's Joe Crump. Here's another video in the $8 startup training series. The whole reason I'm doing these videos, by the way, is just to get you educated with how the system works and ways that you can do it manually if you choose not to use the system, because there's a lot of stuff that you can do manually that makes this work, and give you an idea of how to set up autoresponders and how lists work, and to give you an idea as well how this the whole system kind of interacts together and was designed in a bunch of different pieces over a long period of time and is now put together so that it's integrated. And this next video here is about lead responses and lead response categories. And I've talked a little bit about this, but I want to show you how these lead responses work. If I have this email here and he says, yes, I want to do it, but I want to do it with a down payment. Well, whenever we get a yes or a maybe, and this would be a maybe because he's not getting $15,000 from us, then we would put him in the yes category. So he's classified as a yes here. If that was accidentally miscategorized by the system, by the classification filters, and it was a no, then I could click on this no or this thumbs down and change its classification. And it would not only change it here, but it would change it into in Contactor Plus. Right now, it's set as a yes, and it goes. It takes this lead. It takes this information here. And if you'll notice now, I've got their real email address. I don't have a Craigslist.org email address when we get into the replies. And the whole point of sending out to the Craigslist emails and getting replies is so we can capture their email address, whether it's yes, no, or maybe. And that's the percentage that we're getting back are the actual real email addresses that we can gather, and then we can send out follow-up emails to those people on a regular basis in a sequence in order to continually drip on them until they buy or until they die. So if we put this, or if it's automatically put into the yes category, I can go to Contactor Plus, and I can go to Campaigns and Show, and you're going to have the autoresponder, this Contactor Plus autoresponder, as part of the clone sites. So basically what's happening is the Automarketer is feeding the leads that it's getting over to Contactor Plus on your websites, and it's putting them into different categories. And each one of those categories is a different system. And we're using it more often here on this A, B, and C. These are the three categories that are for the Automarketer. This is for yes. This is interested yes with a phone number. And this is not interested at all, where this is a no. We still follow up with the no's. We just follow up in a different way. On this one, they're automatically getting an email. If I go over here, I can click on messages, and I can see the four emails that they're going to get. This first email talks about what we do, how we do it. It sends them to the website, which I'm going to show you more about these websites later. The website is the rent-to-own seller site that sells them on the idea of working with us using the for-rent method. And so it links up to that and drives them to the clone sites to sell them on the idea of working with us. If they don't say yes to us, then 4 days later, it sends them another one. Hey, did you get my offer? I'm still interested in buying. Here's what we do. And then another one 4 days after that. Which, is it still for sale? We're still interested in buying it if you want to sell it. And then 15 days after that, we get another email that says, hey, I'm still interested in buying. If you've changed your mind, I'd still love to work with you. And that will then go out every 15 days forever, for the rest of their lives, as long as you've got this system set up. And you can go into any one of these emails, and you can modify it, and you can change it any way you like if you want to do it. Or if you want to add a different campaign, you can do that as well. If you'd like to add a different campaign, and let's say instead of having it go to let me go back here to the campaign. Let's say I don't want it to go to this A, but I want to create a new campaign. I can create a new campaign in this system, a new follow-up campaign, and it'll maybe just like one of these. This is a rent-to-own buyers campaign. Let's say I want it to go to this rent-to-own buyers campaign. I can do that simply by going back to Contactor Plus setup in the Automarketer and scrolling down the page, and I can see, oh, if they say yes, or if I've got the thumbs up marked, I want it to go to the buyers, rent-to-own buyers. Now, there's no reason you'd want to do that. I'm just showing you that you can create new campaigns, and you can send them out to those people based on the three criteria that we have. It has to be one of those three criteria, but that's the way it's set up. Right now, it's set up so that if they say yes, they get this category here or this campaign here. If they say, I've got a phone number, yes with a phone number, then they get this one. If they say no, then they get this one. So that's how this this system works. Contactor Plus, autoresponders, sequential email autoresponders that send out a sequence of emails over time, dripping on a customer or a prospective customer over time, is the most powerful marketing tool I've ever used, hands down, for anything, even above the Automarketer. Once you get them in the system and you have a list, you have a list of people that you can keep sending to over and over again, then after a while, these people start coming out of the woodwork and they start saying, yeah, I am interested. When they keep getting our follow-ups, that's when we start hearing back from these folks. It doesn't always happen the first week or the first month or even the first 3 months. But when you've had somebody, I've got people on my list that have been there for more than a decade. And the last event that I had somebody that got onto my list in 1999, so who just finally signed up for my program after all that time, simply because they've been on my list and they've been getting email from me the whole time. And we're going to set up this system so that these people will continue to get emails as well. And if you're getting buyers, you start building your buyers list. And a lot of my students have buyer lists that are, 500, 1,000, 2,000 strong. We're not using this particular system for buyers right now. I have different systems set up for different things for me personally, but yours, you'll be able to access it all from one place. I'm working in a bunch of different states, so it's a little different for me. And you can do the same thing, by the way, and you can set up multiple accounts for different states if you choose to do that as well. Anyway, that's the gist of how these campaigns work and how you can change them and how the autoresponder works. It's one of the coolest marketing tactics that you can use.